Should you upgrade your bullseyes for the new blockhead? Which one should you print, the bullseyes or the blockhead? In today's episode, I compare side by side the original bullseyes with the new blockhead on the industry pro. The bullseyes work with the Ender-3 stock fan, while the blockhead requires to buy and connect a more powerful 5015 fan. The bullseyes requires to be printed with supports. The blockhead is self-supporting by design. Thanks to the very good design, the bullseyes and the blockhead share a common base, and it is very easy to swap between the two. Let's first compare the noise and the airflow of these two cooling modes with a water test. As expected, the blockhead provides significantly more cooling at the expense of additional noise. By reducing the fan speed of the blockhead to about 75%, we can get a similar noise level, but with a better airflow. Now let's compare the print quality between the bullseyes and the blockhead. To compare the print quality, I use a cooling fan torture test from TeachingTech. The torture test provides a difficult bridge, challenging overhangs up to 80 degrees in 4 directions, and a very small and high central spire. All these features are difficult to print and put 3D printers cooling to the limit. The printing quality with the bullseyes is pretty good, but things get even better with the blockhead. The central spire is better defined, the bridge and the overhangs look better. The difference is probably hard to see on the video, but when comparing the two parts side by side, there is no doubt that the printing quality is better with the blockhead. Finally, let's print a very challenging 240mm long bridge. This is just for fun, as in practice, no parts designed for 3D printing should require such a long bridge. The bullseyes failed that test, but the blockhead managed to pull that off. Okay, time for a conclusion. I think the blockhead is even better than the original bullseyes. It is easier to print than the bullseyes, it improves the print quality and provides better bridges and overhangs. The main drawback of the blockhead is the noise of the 5015 fan. The blockhead also requires to replace the stock fan. If you are interested to install the blockhead on your Ender-3, I created a video showing step by step how to do it. That's it for today. Do not forget to subscribe to get a notification when I release a new video. Thanks for watching. See you soon on new MakeTech.